Breaking, Traitor Bergdahl just learned his shocking fate, now look what's happening. In 2014, former President Barack Obama traded five of the worst terrorists in Gitmo for Bo Bergdahl, the army deserter who walked off his base in Afghanistan in 2009. This prisoner exchange was immediately criticized by conservatives and many others considering the ramifications of Bergdahl's actions. In case anyone forgot, when Bergdahl abandoned his post in 2009, six brave men went out in search of him and ended up dying in their efforts to save Bergdahl, who they thought was forcefully captured. Now, after 3 years, Bergdahl is facing the consequences of his actions and agreed to plead guilty to desertion a couple of weeks ago. Now, after all these years, the Bo Bergdahl saga has finally come to an end, but the judge's ruling hardly fits the crime, and has the majority of Americans asking how did this happen? The case of Bergdahl has angered Americans for the last 3 years considering the controversy that swirled around his capture and his return home. After Bergdahl walked off his post, his plan was not to return to his army base, but the six brave men who went out to search for him were not aware of his treason and were killed looking for him, which Bergdahl does not seem to be all that upset about in previous interviews. Here is more from USA Today. Sergeant Bo Bergdahl, the soldier who deserted his Afghanistan outpost and was then held captive in brutal conditions for 5 years, received no prison time but was reduced on rank to private and will be dishonorably discharged from the army, a military judge ruled Friday. In announcing the punishment, the military judge, Colonel Jeffrey Nance, rejected a prosecutor's recommendation to sentence Bergdahl to 14 years confinement. Nance did not elaborate on his decision before dismissing the court. Defense attorneys had argued against prison time, saying the soldier already suffered enough while in Taliban hands. Bergdahl did not react as the sentence was read. He stood flanked by defense lawyers as the judge read sentence and left the courtroom with his attorneys. Bergdahl pled guilty to desertion and misbehavior before the enemy and faced a potential life sentence. During a sentencing hearing, prosecutors argued Bergdahl's actions prompted a desperate manhunt that risked soldiers' lives and led to at least three serious injuries. The ruling brings an end to a polarizing saga that began in 2009 with Bergdahl's decision to walk off a remote combat outpost in Afghanistan. He was quickly captured and endured 5 years of torture and mistreatment at the hands of the Taliban. Defense attorneys described Bergdahl, 31, as a troubled young man who suffered from a personality disorder that made him susceptible to grandiose fantasies and conspiracies and who was often confused about the consequences of his actions. Sergeant Bergdahl has been punished enough, Captain Nina Banks, a defense attorney, said in closing arguments Thursday. This ruling hardly seems like the outcome the traitor deserves considering that Bergdahl openly admitted to walking off his base and willingly converted to Islam. In 2014, former President Barack Obama traded five of the worst terrorists in Gitmo for Bo Bergdahl, the army deserter who walked off his base in Afghanistan in 2009. This prisoner exchange was immediately criticized by conservatives and many others considering the ramifications of Bergdahl's actions. In case anyone forgot, when Bergdahl abandoned his post in 2009, six brave men went out in search of him and ended up dying in their efforts to save Bergdahl, who they thought was forcefully captured. Now, after 3 years, Bergdahl is facing the consequences of his actions and agreed to plead guilty to desertion a couple of weeks ago. Now, after all these years, the Bo Bergdahl saga has finally come to an end, but the judge's ruling hardly fits the crime, and has the majority of Americans asking how did this happen? The case of Bergdahl has angered Americans for the last 3 years considering the controversy that swirled around his capture and his return home. After Bergdahl walked off his post, his plan was not to return to his army base, but the six brave men who went out to search for him were not aware of his treason and were killed looking for him, which Bergdahl does not seem to be all that upset about in previous interviews. Six soldiers died while searching for Bo Bergdahl. However, instead of the traitorous individual receiving a lengthy prison sentence, the judge shocked the court by allowing Bergdahl to walk free. Here is more from USA Today. Sergeant Bo Bergdahl, The soldier who deserted his Afghanistan outpost and was then held captive in brutal conditions for 5 years, received no prison time but was reduced on rank to private and will be dishonorably discharged from the army, a military judge ruled Friday. In announcing the punishment, the military judge, Colonel Jeffrey Nance, rejected a prosecutor's recommendation to sentence Bergdahl to 14 years confinement. Nance did not elaborate on his decision before dismissing the court. Defense attorneys had argued against prison time, saying the soldier already suffered enough while in Taliban hands. Bergdahl did not react as the sentence was read. He stood flanked by defense lawyers as the judge read sentence and left the courtroom with his attorneys. Bergdahl pled guilty to desertion and misbehavior before the enemy and faced a potential life sentence. During a sentencing hearing, prosecutors argued Bergdahl's actions prompted a desperate manhunt that risked soldiers' lives and led to at least 3 serious injuries. The ruling brings an end to a polarizing saga that began in 2009 with Bergdahl's decision to walk off a remote combat outpost in Afghanistan. He was quickly captured and endured 5 years of torture and mistreatment at the hands of the Taliban. Defense attorneys described Bergdahl, 31, as a troubled young man who suffered from a personality disorder that made him susceptible to grandiose fantasies and conspiracies and who was often confused about the consequences of his actions. Sergeant Bergdahl has been punished enough, Captain Nina Banks, a defense attorney, said in closing arguments Thursday. This ruling hardly seems like the outcome this traitor deserves, considering that Bergdahl openly admitted to walking off his base and willingly converted to Islam. In 2014, Fox News reported about Bergdahl's captivity and how he was less than a hostage and more of a friend to those who have pledged to harm Americans. U.S. Army Sergeant Bo Bergdahl at one point during his captivity converted to Islam, fraternized openly with his captors and declared himself a mujahid, or a warrior for Islam, according to secret documents prepared on the basis of a purported eyewitness account and obtained by Fox News. The reports indicate that Bergdahl's relations with his Haqqani captors morphed over time, from periods of hostility, where he was treated very much like a hostage, to periods where, as one source told Fox News, he became much more of an accepted fellow than is popularly understood. He even reportedly was allowed to carry a gun at times. The documents show that Bergdahl at one point escaped his captors for 5 days and was kept, upon his recapture, in a metal cage, like an animal. In addition, the reports detail discussions of prisoner swaps and other attempts at a negotiated resolution to the case that appear to have commenced as early as the fall of 2009. The reports are rich in on-the-ground detail, including the names and locations of the Haqqani commanders who ran the 200-man rotation used to guard the Idaho native, and present the most detailed view yet of what Bergdahl's life over the past 5 years has been like. These real-time dispatches were generated by the Eclipse Group, a shadowy private firm of former intelligence officers and operatives that has subcontracted with the Defense Department and prominent corporations to deliver granular intelligence on terrorist activities and other security-related topics, often from challenging environments in far-flung corners of the globe. This sentence is absolutely disgusting and a slap in the face to those who died attempting to find Bo Bergdahl after he walked off his base. However, even as deplorable as this ruling is, it is not a total surprise considering that most judges and courts around America have a liberal agenda. Stay tuned for more information as this breaking story unfolds.